today we are going to be recording some data for our Sanders Water Lab. So this, it's kind of a boring lab just because we're doing a lot of waiting, but this is kind of what we have to do to get our data. So the first thing is I want to show you the setup. So I've got this ring stand, and it's got a light attached to it. This is a heat lamp. I've got a beaker full of sand with a thermometer inside, and then I've got a beaker full of water with a thermometer inside. So what we're going to do is we are actually going to be using our table. We are going to create our data or collect our data. We're going to do 10 minutes with this heat lamp on and then 10 minutes with this heat lamp off and kind of look at the change to see what's happening. Now, we do have some downtime in between. You're going to see every minute you're going to be waiting around for my timer to ring. So if you look on the back, here is a graph for you, and it says to use brown and blue for sand and water. So you can go ahead and start graphing your data as we go. The time is on the bottom, so then that means temperature should go on the side, okay? So first thing we need to do is we need to get our initial temperatures. So my initial temperature for the sand is about 24.1 degrees Celsius. And then for the water, I have 24.3 degrees Celsius. And, you know, it all just depends on the temperature that of the room that I'm in right now, if I've been touching things, all that kind of stuff. Okay? So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go ahead and start turning on the lamp. And again, every minute that you hear my buzzer go off, I'll say the temperature for each the sand and the water, okay? And we'll get started. And again, as you're waiting, you can maybe work on something in between. Just make sure that you're listening for the timer and then for the readings that I'm going to give you. So, for my sand, I have 25.3, and for my water, I have 24.6. So I have for my sand 25.6 and my water I have 24.8. So for sand, 25.8, and for water, 25.2. Okay, for sand, 26.2, and for water, 25.4. So now for sand, I have 26.5, and water, I have 25.7. Sand, 26.8, and water, I have 26.0. Sand, I have 27.2. And for water, I have 26.2. So you should start seeing how they are both increasing, but making some sort of observations about specifically the sand versus the water. So we've got about 3 minutes left with the light on, and then we're going to turn the light off. And remember to start your graphing if you haven't done that. for sand, I have 27.9. And for the water, I have 26.7. For sand, 28.3 degrees, and for water, I have 27.0. It's our last minute with the lamp on, and then we'll turn it off. And again, as you are getting these measurements, you can be working on your graph on the back. Start setting up your y-axis, giving it a title, and plotting the points for the sand and the water that you currently have. Okay, so now I'm going to turn the lamp off, but I'm going to get my measurements. So I have 28.7 for sand and 27.2 for water. So for sand, I have 29.0, and for water, I have 27.2. Okay, for sand, I have 29.2, and for water, 27.6. for sand, I have 29.2. And for water, I have 27.5. For sand, I have 29.1, and for water, I have 27.4. For sand, I have 28.8, and for water, 27.3. Here are some measurements in case you need to catch up. Sand, I have 28.7. Water, I have 27.2. Sand, 28.6, and water, 27.1.
have about two more times after this. So for sand, I have 28.4, and for water, I have 27.1 still. Sand, I have 28.2, and water, I have 27.0. And this will be our last measurement. So in about 40 seconds, we'll take our last measurement. And for our last measurements, I have 28.1, and for my water, I have 26.9 degrees Celsius. Okay. So here is the information, if you can see that. Okay, you can pause it if you need to. And then once you are done and you have all this information, remember, if you haven't started already, you need to complete your graph. So remember, temperature goes on the left. You've got your time on the bottom. And then you're going to complete your CER. So where your CER says, your claim, what you learned, your evidence is your exact data from the graph and from the table, and how your evidence supports your claim. Okay? So again, complete your graph and then work on your CER.